So guys, I've been thinking, and I think we need a better villager trading hall because J-Trade isn't exactly that good at the moment, and it's quite small and the prizes are quite expensive, so I've been thinking I really want to build a new villager trading hall, and because I'm like the enchanted book guy on the server, so I think it's only reasonable that I have a proper villager trading hall to get all my books from. So yeah, and I've come up with a design in my creative testing world. So I think let's just waste no time and let's get into building it. But first, I have gravel, but I have no sand. And I need sand for concrete. Let's go. So guys, we're flying to where the villager trading hall is going to be, and I did some work off camera, and yeah, I meant to build up a bit of the walls, and I got a little bit carried away with myself. So yeah, this is pretty much what it's going to be like. So I want to go for like a giant rectangular octagon. So here, I have some diamonds, let me get them out.
Wait, I have some bone meal.
My richity box. Okay, so it was one stack of diamonds, wasn't it?
Yeah. For one block, yes.
Yes, okay.
Actually, that's way too cheap, but sure.
Cheap? What?
It's 81. It's meant to be 81 diamonds. 9 times 9.
Okay, I'm getting a good deal. Give me the block. Hey, give it back. Stop placing it. No, go away. It is mine. And I have scammed you. No, I'm joking.
Troy, if you don't tell me, then I'll get annoyed at you, and
there you go.
I'll be annoyed at you.
They're wet diamonds. I'm really sorry. And here's your tip. Here's your tip.
Oh, thank you. 16. Okay, thanks.
You're welcome. Now I have another right block. So guys, I've been doing a little bit of work off camera, and we all know episode 2 was a bit of a failure, and yes, I've done it. I've reconstructed the cobblestone generator off camera, and this thing was reasonably difficult to make. It's an Il Mango farm, so kind of obvious it's difficult to make. And yeah, it looks really ugly, but it is awfully laggy. I get really low FPS when this thing is on. FPS now is around 60, maybe 30, but that's like level, yeah. And so if I turn this thing on, it's gonna create, the FPS is gonna be absolutely awful. See it? Sprays it, and this thing actually works this time. And it's so scary when it just keeps coming closer. It sort of glitches in. And you get a lot of cobble from this. It's really laggy. You can see how laggy this thing is. I don't really know what to do about this. It's so painfully laggy. Il Mango, you lag every server. So I'm really happy that this is working. So, I'm never gonna ever leave this thing on unless I need cobble. And this means no mining for cobble ever again. Yay! And it's just awesome how it just doesn't blow up the platform. So, and it's really. This breast, you can see, look at this block over here. Just glitches. You can just look at it. It's glitches. I can't even see anything. It's so painfully laggy, so I'm gonna have to work on how to fix that. Boom. Okay. So I haven't got a great storage system. It's pretty much this so far, but it's pretty decent on the cobble front. And yeah, there's quite a lot of cobble just sat up there. So guys, we are here, and you may be wondering, okay, this is ridiculous. You said you were going to do some off camera, but you did far too much off camera. The funny thing is, I did some of it on stream, like you probably know the first little bit on stream, and this roof I meant to do on the Sunday stream, but the Sunday stream, I didn't actually realise I wasn't actually streaming, I was just recording. So I have a long bit of footage from that, which corrupted because it was in stream format. So yeah, this is pretty much what we did. We made this really nice glass roof, and it looks really cool. So you can fly here, and yeah, we have all the lights here. And so guys, there's been a pretty big time gap between the last time I was online, and you probably noticed that because my shovel's a bit different. And yeah, I've done a little bit of work on the this over tin, excuse me. Yeah, I've done a little bit of work on here, and there's just a tree on top, I don't know why. It's a giant Christmas tree. And as you can probably tell, we've got these really nice cyan terracotta little rings around it. Just making sure no creeper's gonna sneak up and blow this place up. Yeah, so I'm gonna have these nice cyan, like, you know, stripes around it all the way to the back, and I think that would look kinda nice. And the second thing you're gonna notice is got some inhabitants in there. And yeah, now I need to show you this. So if we pop down here, I have a creeper. Please don't blow up. There we go. So yeah, I've done quite a lot of work here. So I've got all the sides in, and there's some villagers here. Hello, sir. And I'm really happy with the progress I've made, because I click on this guy, one emerald for aqua affinity, one emerald. How crazy is that? So yeah, I have cured up all these villages. So I've infected them with zombie, and then I've cured all of them up. So Now all of them have really nice zombie traits. So we have Aqua Affinity. We also have Death Strider 3. It's only the first book I'm showing, by the way. Yeah, so over here we have some Fortune 3 for one emerald, gets me Fortune 3. This guy Impaling 5 for one emerald. Looting 3, I think this guy is. Yeah, Looting 3. And it used to cost 32 emeralds, now it costs 1. And I can also get these, which is what I'll show you something cool I can do after. This guy, Mending for 1 emerald. Then there's various other villages. These are Protection and Projectile Protection. This guy's Respiration 3. Sharpness 5. Silk Touch and Smite 5. But this guy also deals with Efficiency, so I don't think I'm going to need to get an Efficiency villager in just yet. This guy's Sweeping Edge 3. And does Riptide 2. I could just buy 2 of them if I want. This is just temporary. He'll pathfind over. We have a Thorns guy. And I'm sorry, sir. Oh, you didn't get angry at me. Oh, okay, thank you, that's good. We have 2 Thorns, and this guy's just standing here. That's a rip-off of Fire Aspect. And this guy's Unbreaking. So yeah, we have quite a few villages and some other mini inhabitants here who are just roaming around the place. And yeah, that was a bit of a mind up there. I resorted to a different method of zombie curing. So I would just get a giant dark chamber, fly up into the sky, come down gradually so zombies would only spawn in here. Have a few mobs in here, kill all the others, make sure it's just zombies, then deliver the villager into here and the zombie would infect the villager. Then I would kill the zombie and cure the villager. So that was pretty simple methodology of doing it. And yeah, I don't think I'm going to get any more villagers in for the time being. I'm just going to leave some inhabitants here. The only thing I don't really like is we have this giant glass thing here. And that is kind of annoying because if you don't have a elytra, you're pretty much doomed. I mean, you can do this, but yeah. On the way out, people are always complaining that they can't get in, even though I don't see why they would need to get in. So yeah, I can just fly, so it's fine for me. And yep, I got my fly elytra back. Because I had an unenchanted one, and I got some netherite leggings, which is pretty cool. So guys, I just want to take you through the process of how I would get lots and lots of enchanted books. So what I would do is I would just come here with a few emeralds, say about 24, sounds good to me, and I would just head over to just a random guy. This guy seems to be Mending. So then I would go over here and see, okay, this costs 4 emeralds for bookshelf. Nope. So I'll go over to another guy, see how much is your bookshelf. You don't have any. Yours, 4. Yours, you don't have any. You don't have any either. So I just keep looking for the bookshelf trade. So perfect. This guy, Sharpness 5 guy, has a bookshelf trade. And each bookshelf costs 1 emerald. So just hold shift and click. And I get 12 bookshelves. And that's why I need this other axe. Wait, what? Excuse me? So rude. I don't even have a good trade, sir. So now I'll just chop it down. So we're going to chop it and we're going to get loads of these books. We should have 36, yep. So I come up to this guy and nope, nothing. So I come up to this guy. He has another bookshelf trade, so I mean, we might as well just grab more to show you. There we go, so let me just break it all down. There we go, so we have a stack and 8. So then what I do is I come over to a guy and find, okay, look, so he has the book trade. 12 emeralds. He doesn't? Nope, not yet. Do you have it? Oh, do you have it, sir? Have it? We have our 24 emeralds back and 48 books. So one book equals one emerald. So every emerald we have, it essentially triples, which I think is absolutely crazy with this little, I wouldn't call it an exploit, but yeah. What else would you call it? So I can just keep coming around, finding guys who have a book trade. You have it, hello, sir. And I already have 48 emeralds, I've already doubled it. Do you have book trade? Book trade? Nope, no book trades. And did you have a book trade, sir? You had a book trade. So from 24 emeralds, we made a stack and 8. So then I can come round here and find another bookshelf trade and buy bookshelves. So this is the way I get loads of books. I essentially get it for free. I think this is absolutely insane. So do try this in single player worlds. If you have a single player world or if you play on a server, do try this. All you have to do is cure up these villages and make sure they have a bookshelf trade. So you just keep coming in, just redoing this trade and getting tons and tons of this stuff. And it is absolutely crazy how Mojang haven't seen this. And they probably have. They probably think, oh, it's fair, because it takes a lot of resources to cure them and, you know, uncure them. And wait, no. What? Never mind. So yeah, so then I'd come over to my mending guy and I'd go mending and just, yep, I got 12 mending books, I think that was. And I'd come up to looting and hey, I want some looting. Grab a load of looting. And yep, there we go. So then what I do is I take my books and all my books. So many books now. So essentially I have an inventory filled up with enchanting books. So I'll take it to my... Who's done this? Soulfire lanterns? Or just soul lanterns or whatever they're called. And okay, I think there seems to have been an accident. Anyways, so this is mending. So I'll just go to mending. Where's mending? Mending. And just send it all into the chest. Then where's looting? Looting's over here. And I've officially changed all my prices on the storefront, I think it is, to 1 diamond per book. And people have seen this. And yeah, so officially now all prices are 1 diamond per book. Have I made any stonks? Doesn't appear to. Have I made any? It's annoying. Please take from the edge, people. Fortune normally sells fast. So yeah, my goal is to just completely have this place completely stocked at all times. And there seems to be some minor damages in there. Can I fix that? Any white concrete? No. Well, I mean, the next step up from white concrete is netherrack, so, you know, that will just have to do. And here we go, look. Looks pretty good to me. Yeah, people won't notice the difference. It looks the same. There's so many holes around the shopping district. And there has been a major expansion by some of the members, and doesn't seem to be completely done, but we're doing a major expansion, and I did make this, yes, I made this, and I will explain to you what this is going to be in a future episode. So, you can look forward to reading that lectern and finding out what all this is going to be about. I hereby name this Lake Stormcraftio. So guys, I've just popped into the Nether to get something, and I've seen these amazing tunnels, and I believe these were built by Ethani, and these things just look amazing. They're just really cool. Little blackstone and basalt tunnels, and there's some stuff here. What's this? Probably the materials he was using. So yeah, this is pretty good stuff. These tunnels are really nice and accessible, and you can get lost in them. It's like a maze. I don't think you thought of that, Ethani. It's a maze. All I know is the shopping district is here, and my base is right over there, down here. That's all I know. I think I'm not sure what's down here. This is a maze. I think this way is. Where is this way? Whose portal is this? Probably see. Oh, here. This is Ethani's portal. So yeah, as I was gonna show you now, I have built something on the Nether roof in a live stream, which I wanted to show you guys. And what is all this here? Who has been? Oh, I think this is a piglin trading thing. Piggy Wiggy. I'm getting distracted too much. So I think it's in this direction. So I've built something on the live stream, as I said. It's really big and it's in the sky. And yeah, I built a gold farm. A humongous overpowered gold farm, which is also an XP farm, which is pretty cool. So it's need I say more? Now there's one major problem. When you start coming here, it's all crazy efficient and everything, but that is because the mobs can also spawn down below the Nether roof. And also I can hit this button and it also becomes an XP grinder, so I can whack them and I get some XP from them. I can repair up all my gear. So that is pretty cool. So I can just turn XP mode off. And yeah, as you can see, after a while, it pretty much stops. They just get stuck there. And that's because they're supposed to get stuck there, but the other pigmen are supposed to come and push them. The only problem is, below the Nether roof, lots and lots of mobs are spawning. And pigmen, piglins, all of these mobs. And yeah, I'm getting quite a bit of rotten flesh, which I don't need, so I just check out. So the mobs spawn and it takes up the mob cap, which means mobs will spawn less frequently there. And yeah, I've just recently emptied it out, and yeah, I wanted to show you how much gold I actually get from this. So if I wanted to properly AFK this thing overnight or something, I would stand here, and that means no mobs could spawn onto the nether roof, everything would be nice and good. So yeah. So they spawn here, then they get lured towards turtle eggs, and they pretty much fall because there's trapdoors there, and they think they can walk across it, and they die. So I think they spawn in, I think when they spawn in like groups of, big groups of that, I think that's called pack spawning, if I get that right. Technical terms, yeah, lots of them spawn, it's pack spawning. So then we look down there, you can see we get quite a lot of them spawning. If I press F1, you can just see the sheer, that is what the farm should be like if I manage to spawn proof all below the nether. So right now I have one of two options. One would be to completely fill in all under the nether roof, so to build blocks all under the nether roof and fill it in completely, so no mobs can spawn under there. Well, actually I have three options. The second option would be to spawn proof the whole place, to go around every spawnable block and place carpets or slabs or anything spawn proof, just completely spawn proof the place so they won't be able to spawn in. That's option number two. Option number three is to make a perimeter which would completely decimate all the blocks down to bedrock, so absolutely none of them would spawn. And I don't think it would need to be down to bedrock, because I think over here, if I can just land here, yeah, get quite a lot of them spawning. This is level, I think, 199. Yeah, 199. And 199 minus 128, which is the spawn radius around the player they can spawn, is, I believe, level 71. So I think I would only need to dig down to level 70 anywhere, or all on the map. And yeah, we should be good to go. So if I just, how did you spawn here? I think, I'm pretty sure I spawned, yeah, so you can see it's pretty good. We get quite a bit of gold from this thing. So let me come up here and let me just craft this into gold ingots and then gold blocks. We get about 3 gold blocks from that, which isn't the greatest, but once you see how much I have in here, you're gonna think this is amazing. So I'm gonna open this box in 5 seconds, okay? 5, 4, and nah, just open it now. I have an absolute sheer ton of gold. 5.5 stacks of gold blocks. If we wanted to count properly, that's 5 stacks and 38. And I like to sort it like this a bit, so I can just come here if I want, just do this. I like this, so then I take multiples of 9 over here. Oh, actually, wait. In that case, I would only need to pop that in there, because that would give me an extra ingot. So I'd come here, craft up an ingot, and craft these into blocks. So yeah, I think I'm just going to leave it as it is at the moment. Nice and sorted. So occasionally, once I have like all this filled up, no, that's not creative glitch, it just shows like that. I can just magic. Oh look, magic's create loads of stacks all over the place. No, that is not possible in survival. There is no magic Minecraft hack you can do. No. Yeah, so once I have all this filled up with stacks completely here, then I'll probably take it and craft it into gold ingots. So yeah. Let me just pop this back in my ender chest. So this is the gold farm I built off camera. And yeah, it is a Nembon design. His video will be linked down in the description if you want to see how to build this yourself. And yeah, it's a pretty simple design. So yeah, it's pretty cool. It took a lot of magma to build this. It took about 4 shulker boxes of magma, about 2 stacks of grindstones, about another two stacks of trapdoors, about 25 turtle eggs. So yeah, if I come over here, get a nice view of grindstones, has just stopped them completely getting stuck. So one of them go fast. We have turtle eggs here to lure them in. And sometimes guys get stuck, but it should be fine. More should come and push them. But yeah, I have to stand all the way over here. I can't just stand on top of there, because there's a radius around the player. I think it's 25 blocks that mobs can't spawn. So yeah, that isn't great if they can't spawn on the top few layers. That's just decreasing efficiency. So I really like this farm. I'm really happy with how it turned out. And I hope you guys are too. So I'm probably going to be getting all my gold from here now. I mean, where else would I get my gold? And I think a project to work on over the next few days, maybe weeks for me, would be to completely, well, first of all, decide what plan I want to do. I think I'm going to leave that up to you guys, what I should do. Should I completely fill it in, completely dig a hole down to level 70, or just spawn proof the place all over? which I think spawn proofing is probably the most difficult, because if you miss a spot, then yeah, it won't work. So I think I'm going to leave it to completely filling in the place or completely mining out the place. If you really want to spawn proof, you can say that, because I don't know, whatever you guys think. So yeah, once I find out what you guys want to do, I'll probably decide a bit too. I'm not going to leave it all up to you guys. So yeah, then I'll take my course of action. This is war spawning. So I mean, what I can do temporarily is just fly up here, up to this layer, so they can't spawn. Then I come down really quickly if I want to get XP. Obviously normal drops mode is fine. So then quickly flick this on. We get quite a few of them here, and this is what it should always be like. I'm just repairing all my gear. Quite a bit of XP. On that note, I think I'm gonna leave it here for today. So we've done quite a lot. We've built our villager trading hall, and that is not yet complete. And I think what I want that to be is like a season-long project that we just occasionally come back, get a few more trades in. Just, yeah, so not like an active project that we're always constantly working on, like something like this. And we built this villager, this piglin thing, which is pretty overpowered and good for gold. So thank you, zombified piglins, for dying for my record. So yeah, as I was saying, this has been me, Cobalt, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.